So it's time to start configuring some asset analytics. And the first one we're going to work on is an analytic that will identify the operating state of each dryer. We're going to do this in three steps, gradually improving our analytic with each step. The first one we're going to build is a good operating state. So the good operating state will use this equation that you see in this slide. And it's pretty simple. We're just going to make the assumption that if the temperature of the dryer outlet is greater than 170 degrees, we'll call that the regenerating state. And if it's below 170 degrees, we'll call that the drying state. Now there's a little bit more to it than that, because we don't want to publish or post to the Pi archive the same value over and over and over again. So we've used the previous value and no output functions of Asset Analytics to allow us to accomplish this. So if we identify that the temperature is greater than 170 degrees, we're first going to check to see if the last time we evaluated this analytic, it had the value of regenerating. And if it did, we're not going to do it. We don't need to add that in there again because we've already posted a value of regenerating into the archive. So we're going to use the no output, which basically means we're going to skip the analytic this time and wait till it gets rescheduled. Same thing true for the drying state. So we're only going to post the value when it's the first time. In other words, when it's a change from the previous state. That'll keep the archive nice and clean, and we'll only have values when the actual changes occur. Now, we're going to be using the preview results function of Asset Analytics to take a look at this once we've configured our rule. And we're going to get some results that look like this. So again, the yellow line is the temperature. The green hashed line is the results of our analytic. And I've got some red boxes drawn there that shows what's happening is that we get kind of some false starts, which is something we're going to have to deal with in the next step. But hopefully, when we use the preview results feature of Asset Analytics to take a look at our results, you will get the same thing as you're seeing in this slide. Okay, now let's get to configuring the analytic. So here we are in Pi System Explorer, and we're looking at the dryer AF model, and we're on the elements page. So in order to configure the Asset Analytic, we're going to add it to the template, the dryer template. To get to the templates, you have to go down and select the library view in the little lower left-hand corner. And you can see if you go up where it says element templates, you should have the dryer, or you should select the dryer template. And then at the top, make sure you click on the analysis templates page to see all the analytics that have been configured for this template. And we're going to add another one. And that's going to be what we're going to call My Dryer State. So in order to add an asset analytic, you click on the little picture up here, this icon where it says New Analysis Template. And you can see that one has been added. So the first thing we're going to do is give it a name. So over in the name field, we're going to go ahead and call this My Dryer State. Now, I would suggest that whenever you create a new analytic that you're testing out, that you uncheck this box. If it's that box really will enable the analytic whenever an element gets created from this template, since we're just trying something new here, we're going to want to control when it gets run and, you know, started and stopped. We haven't even tested it yet. So I would uncheck that box whenever I'm working with something new, because then you have complete control as to when it starts to run. Okay, so we've got the analytic created. We've given it a name. Now what we'd like to do is to go ahead and paste in the expression. So in your workbook, there is the expression is part of the text. And if you just copy and paste that, you can do this rather easily without having to type the expression from scratch, but if you want to do that, you're certainly welcome to. So I've put in our equation for the good operating state. There's a few other things we need to do. One thing that is always helpful is to change the name of the variable. So we have the name of the variable right now is variable one. Well, let's go ahead and call that my state rule. And you can't have any spaces, so they all have to be, all the words have to be put together. See, that looks good. And then the other thing we have to do is we have to map the output to an attribute. So as this calculation runs, we want the results eventually to be posted to a PI tag through the attribute of this template. So when you create a mapping and you click on the mapping link, you'll see that you have access to all the different attributes of this template. And the one that we're going to use is this one called My Operating State. And the ones that are bold are the ones that you have to choose from. The ones that are grayed out are the ones that are already occupied by some other calculation. You can't have two calculations posting values to the same attribute because then things get kind of conflicted. So my operating state is an attribute that we've created for this template, and it has a PI point associated to it for each of the dryers. So you're ready to start filling data in there once you get in the analysis the way you'd like. There's just a few other items to mention before we test our analytic. First, the scheduling of it. And if you look at the bottom of the window, you'll see that we have event triggered selected for the scheduling of this analytic. And that means that it's going to run every time we receive a new value for the dryer outlet temperature. Then in the middle, next to example element, you'll see a link to dryer A. This refers to dryer A's element, which means that when we test things out from here, we're going to be using the data for dryer A. If you click on the link, you'll see that it exposes the list of all elements derived from this template. There are just two here, but there could be many of them. So from the template, you have the ability through this link to pick different elements to test. Now, select your analytic, My Dryer State, and right-click and drop down to the Preview Results item. When the dialog comes up, enter a start time of November 10th, 2019, and end time of November 15th of 2019. Then click Generate Results. This is going to go through and evaluate our analytic for that time range using the data from the PI archive. Now, we're not putting any data back into PI yet. This is a way of testing things out without really doing anything to the PI system at all. So it's kind of an unintrusive way of testing your analytic without actually populating data into a PI tag. Now, we can't see all the data yet. So if you click on the multiple time range button, you'll see that everything comes into view. So the red trace is the outlet temperature, and the blue trace is the results of our analytic. And you can see results that look very similar to what we showed in the PowerPoint. If you want, you can stretch this out a little bit to see a better view. At the top, you see a grid of values. This is going to give us an evaluation of each step of the way throughout that time range, what the results of the calculation is. And you'll notice they're 6 minutes apart. If you recall, at the very beginning of the course, we mentioned that this data comes at a 6 minute cadence. So we can see that we do have an issue because at the beginning of the regeneration cycle, you see that the data is kind of jittery. We're getting some false starts. You can, you know, use the zoom feature to take a closer look if you want. So we'll go in here and zoom in. And you can see that looks like the temperature goes up above 170, and then very shortly thereafter it goes below, kind of bobbles around until it finally goes all the way up. This is the problem we're going to have to solve. We'll do that in the next exercise with the better operating state. However, if you want to take a closer look at this, you'll notice that in the lower right-hand corner of this dialog, there's a button that says Export Results. If you click on that, what will happen is it will generate a CSV file of the data you see above in the grid, and then you can do further analysis if you'd like inside Excel. Sometimes it's easier to look at things there. Okay, this concludes this particular hands-on exercise. We have some work to do, so let's get on with revising our analytic, making a better operating state analytic.